Hello. Today we're looking at Makulu Linux 15, the core edition. And for me, this is one of the best ex-Ubuntu-based distributions I've seen in a long while. It is, if we look at the bad things first and then to the better things, it is a bit heavy on resources. So as you can see, it's about 800 megabytes of RAM, and for ex-Ubuntu, for XCE, it's quite a lot. It is based on Debian testing, so not Xubuntu, but it's XCE. And as you can see, by if you look at it at the beginning, it looks a lot like Mac OS with your bottom dock here. And you think, where is the whisker menu? Where is all these cool things? And if you go to the top corner here, you get your circle menu of GNOME, and as you can see, it works very well, it looks very cool, and it's just a very smart menu. If you go to your bottom corner, and this sometimes doesn't work immediately, the whisker menu appears here. So it's really cool how they like hide everything and put it all like nicely together, which is a brilliant idea. So you got your whisker menu, you got your GNOME menu, and you got your dock. So you got three menus which all works very good, and as you can see, it just works out of the box. So memory wise, a gigabyte for Xubuntu is heavy, but it's a fully packed. So if you like sleek, clean, very light distros, this is most probably not for you. But if you like something which was clearly a lot of love given to, then this is a great distro. And there's a lot of apps hidden inside here. If you right click on your desktop, you get all your options. There's a lot of wallpapers that use variety as the wallpaper choice. Some of them, a mix of everything is here. As you can see, you can sweep easily between them. Something for everyone. Which is fantastic. And it's kernel 4.19, so it's an up-to-date kernel. And another neat app is this little web applets. And you say yes. There's so many things in this distro which is worth checking out. So you got your normal social media stuff here, your Google stuff here. And then you get your web applets, which you can choose whatever you want. And you can even make new ones. So that's quite cool. And then you can choose what you want. So let's say I want Mega. So then you have a quick access to your Mega Cloud to the top. So that's really, really neat. And you got your indicators here at the left. And if you right click on your desktop, you see there's a 3D on off option. If you say yes, and all the screen window tiling things, they all work. That's fantastic. And we will soon get something. So let's open up a terminal. You will see you got your wobbly windows, you got your squares, and you got all these slick things all to do with 3D, and you can easily turn it off. Sometimes it takes a few seconds to like adapt the new Windows system, which is fine. As you can see, we have to wait a few seconds, so sometimes it's not too fast. But besides from that, and as you can see, it's no 1.6 gigabytes of RAM, so the RAM is a lot. But, and sometimes like little mistakes like this happen, so it's not perfect, but there's so much potential in this system, which make it a great and exciting prospect. The system settings is looking really good, and something happened here. So as you can see, it's not perfect yet, and I hope the guy who made this system will just continue to improve it, because there's so many good things packed inside here. It uses Funer as a file manager. as you can see. So now we kind of got a little mistake going on here. Let's try to turn on the 3D again. So there is mistake still, it's not perfect yet, and but there's so much potential for one of the best destroys out there, and I'm dead serious with it. I really think they got lots of potential here for something amazing. There's a few bugs, as you can see right now, and I tried several times to run. Maybe it's because I'm running this inverter box. I run all my destroy reviews in VirtualBox because I just can't afford another HDMI output computer. But they got so much potential here for a great, great distro, and for me, VirtualBox, it's key to have your things working well in VirtualBox because it's where people most of the time try things out, and if they like it, they will put it on hardware. But if it doesn't really work well, so I hope it's been checked out and also fixed because there's so, so much potential here for a great, great distro. You have your free manager. And we're still going to look at one very cool thing, and here you can choose your themes because we are in the 3D mode. It doesn't change to it, but if you are in normal mode, you can choose your themes here. And then they got a tool which is not free, but it is pretty cool. So it's toolbox, it's not a tool. It is constructor. So here you basically can build your own distro, and then you have what you want, and you can make your like nearly like your own snapshot ISO. Your complete ISO will be put into your home snapshot. So you can use this to customize it as you want, make your own snapshot, and then you have your own ISO or your system exactly how you want. But for that you have to pay some money. And it makes sense because everybody needs money in this world, and this guy put a lot of work into it, and it's just fair that he asked money, I think. So I'm not sure how much money you have to pay for it, but yeah, so for that you have to give him something, and that is absolutely fine, I think, because it gives a distro free if you want to make your own ISO. There you go. And you can set it all up here as you want it and then enjoy it. That's quite cool. And then they also got the toolbox as I saw, which is basically some of the most familiar settings plus a few extra apps. So it's really a cool, handy tool. And I think you've done a great job to put something neat together, and I want to give him a high five. So yeah, so if you give it some time, check it out, because it's something different than the other distros. And Makulu Linux got three distros. They got Lindox, Flash, and Core. So they all got the 15 releases, and I think we checked them all out together. Yeah, so I think it's great, and I think it's absolutely worth checking out. I think the bugs which I experienced simply because I'm running this in VirtualBox, and it should be checked at all, I think. But otherwise than that, fantastic and absolutely worth checking out. Thank you for watching. See you later. Goodbye.